Hello, and welcome to Scrum Study. In the previous videos, we discussed Scrum project organization, and we learned about the different roles that Scrum as a methodology introduces in a project environment, and how Scrum works in different programs and portfolios. In this segment, we'll have a top-down approach to quickly run through the various roles and responsibilities relevant to the organization we've learned so far. So let's get started with the Scrum Guidance Body, or SGB. It has an optional role. It generally consists of a group of documents or a group of experts who are typically involved with defining objectives related to quality, government regulations, security, and other organizational parameters. The Scrum Guidance Body establishes overall guidelines and metrics for developing role descriptions for Scrum team members. It acts as a consultant to projects across organization at different levels. It also understands and defines appropriate levels of groupings, roles, and meetings for Scrum projects. Similar to a project, in portfolios, one of the important roles for managing Scrum is that of a portfolio product owner. He's someone who defines the strategic objectives and priorities for properties. The portfolio Scrum Master is the next role. He or she solves problems and removes impediments and facilitates and conducts meetings for the portfolio. Furthermore, in programs, to manage this, Scrum has an important role called Program Product Owner. He or she defines the strategic objectives and priorities for progress. Program Scrum Master is the next important role in the case of Scrum-run programs. Let's now move on to talk about the non-core roles. Non-core roles are those roles that aren't mandatory for the Scrum project and may not be continuously or directly involved in the Scrum process. One such role we're going to discuss here is the stakeholder role. Stakeholder is a collective term that includes customers, users, and sponsors who frequently interface with the product owner, Scrum Master, and Scrum team to provide them with input and to facilitate creation of the deliverables of the project. Now let's run through the core roles in Scrum. We'll start with the product owner. This person is responsible for achieving maximum business value. The product owner represents the voice of the customer. The main functions performed by the product owner are as follows. The product owner takes the utmost responsibility of creating the project's initial overall requirements and gets the projects rolling. Appointing appropriate people to the Scrum Master and Scrum team roles is another important duty that he performs. He or she provides the initial and ongoing financial resources for the project. He or she determines the product vision. The product owner goes with the onus of assessing the viability and ensuring the delivery of the product or service. It falls under his or her liability to decide minimum marketable release content. He also provides acceptance criteria for the user stories to be developed in a sprint. It's his obligation to inspect deliverables and decide the sprint duration. The next core role we'll discuss is the Scrum Master. He or she ensures that the Scrum processes are correctly followed by all team members, including the product owner, and that the development of the product or service is processing smoothly, and that the Scrum team members have all the necessary tools to get the necessary work done. He or she also oversees the release planning meeting and schedules other meetings. Last, we're going to talk about the Scrum team. In simple terms, the team is responsible for completing the product deliverables for the product owner. The team takes collective responsibility and ensures that the product deliverables are created per requirements. It also assures the product owner and Scrum Master that the allocated work is being performed according to plan. Thank you for learning with us.